Hello and welcome to another video on VBScript. In this video we look at conditional statements. The purpose of conditional statements is to control the flow. Put simply, a conditional statement has a condition and the script takes some actions if the condition is true and some other actions if the script has the condition as false. So let us see the simplest form of the conditional statement, which is the if then statement. So let us say that we have to find out the length of a name. So the flowchart for this problem is, first we start, then we enter the name. It can be any name of any length. Then we have to find out the condition, is a name greater than 5 letters. Now there are two possibilities, the name is 5 or less number of letters, or the name is more than 5 letters. So if the name is more than 5 letters, so the script has to display the name and the length. And if the name is not less greater than 5 characters, then it doesn't do anything, it just stops. So let us see this particular script. So this is a script, and here we have the option explicit statement followed by the declaration of the name variable, and the name simply takes an input from the user. The input box says the prompt, please enter your name, and the title is the name entry, and there is a default value of an empty string. So the name is stored in the name variable. Then we have the if then statement. Now the if then statement is used when there is just one statement to be executed if the condition is true. If the condition is false, then nothing is done. And here the condition is len of name greater than 5. So len is a built-in VBScript function. So what it does is it finds out the length of the string. So it can be 1 character long or 2 character long. So if the length of the name is greater than 5, then a message box will come, otherwise nothing will happen. So let us execute this particular script and see how it works. Now in order to execute the script, either we can give the full name of the script or just the name of the script without the file extension. So here we are getting the input box on line number 3. So it says enter your name, and let us say we enter the name as John. Now John is going to be only 4 characters, so the condition is false, so nothing will happen now. So as you see that the script has terminated and nothing has happened. So let us execute the script one more time, and this time let us give a name which is more than 5 letters long. So let us say I put Victor and click on OK. So here the message box is there because the condition is now true. Now it says the name is Victor and its length is 6 characters. Okay, now let us move on. So sometimes it is possible that we don't just have a single statement to execute if the condition is true. We have a number of statements to execute if the condition is true. So in this particular flowchart we can see that first of all the user enters the name. Then the condition is checked if name is greater than 5 letters. If yes, then it displays the name, it displays the length, so there will be a couple of message boxes, and then stop. If the name is not greater than 5 letters, then it doesn't do anything and it simply stops. So here we are going to use the if then end if statement. So let us see how that looks like. So here we have the statement, and the difference in the input box statement you can see is I have used the trim function. Trim basically removes all the leading spaces and the trailing spaces. So if the user has entered any spaces at the beginning and after that they have given the name and after that they have given any spaces after the end of the name, so trim is going to remove all that. If you just want to remove the leading spaces, that means the spaces before the string, you can use the ltrim built-in VBScript function. If you just want to remove the trailing spaces or spaces after the string, you can use the rtrim function. And if you use the trim function, it is going to remove both the leading spaces and the trailing spaces. And then we have the if statement. So it is if then and if statement, and the entire statements starting from if and ending with end if is called the if block. So there are a couple of message boxes over here, and first it says the name is, and ucase is a built-in VBScript function. It converts any string to uppercase, and similarly we also have the lcase function which converts everything in the string to lowercase. And then there is another message box which says the length of the name is so many characters. So let us execute this script. So please enter your name. So let us say I put a name which is not greater than 5 characters, so nothing happens. So let us execute it one more time. So let us say this time I gave the name as with a length of more than 5 characters. So this is the first message box which is coming from line 5. So it says the name is Robert. It is all in uppercase because we use the ucase function. And then there is another message box which says the length of the name is 6 characters. It's coming from line 6. Now we have also used the trim function. So let us see how that works. So let us say that I want to give some spaces at the beginning, and then I give the name, and then I give some spaces. Now it is going to ignore the spaces at the beginning, at the end, and just take the string in between. In between, if we have any space, that is going to be included. So what is the length of this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 characters. And we have spaces, both the leading spaces and the trailing spaces. But the trim function is going to remove the leading spaces and trailing spaces and just store the name. So here we can see it has just taken the name, removed the spaces, and it says the length of the name is 11 characters. So this is the example of the if then end if statement. The difference between if then statement and if then end if statement is that in if then statement we can put a single line of code, and if we want to put multiple lines of code in our if block, then we have to use if then end if statement. So if the condition is true, all the statements between the if statement and end if statement are going to be executed. So let us go back. Now sometimes what happens, and this is a more realistic case, that if the condition is true, then we want some actions to take place, and if the condition is false, we want some other actions to take place. So this is a flowchart. So here what it says is start, and it checks what is the current time. Is the time before noon? If it is before noon, it goes to the yes direction. So it displays time and good morning greeting. If on the other hand the time is not before noon, then it says displays the time and gives a good day greeting. So let us see this particular script. So here we have the entire if statement, and it has if, else and if. So the condition in this if statement is given in the if statement. Now this particular condition means that, now what we are doing here is there is a variable called strtime which stores time. Time is a built-in function in VBScript. It returns the current time, and that is stored in the strtime variable. Now instring is a built-in VBScript function, so it finds one string within another. So it has three arguments. The first argument is from where it should start the search. So I have given that as 1, which means start the search from the first character. And the second argument is which string it has to search. So it has to search in the strtime, whatever value is there in the strtime variable. And the third argument is what string it has to search. So I have given am. Now if instring function in str function is able to find this particular string am within str time, it's going to return a non-zero value. So if this condition is true, so what we want is we want one set of statements to be executed, what I have selected over here. So there are a couple of rem statements which are nothing but comments. So we can give the comments by using the apostrophe as a first character or by using the rem keyword in VBScript. So it gives a message box, the current time is and whatever value is in the str time, and have a good morning because it is am. If the condition is false, that means the time is not am, then it executes a statement within the else block. So it just says there is a message box, the current time is so much, and have a good day and good night. So let us execute it, and notice right now that the time is 11:47 p.m. on my machine. So I'm going to first of all clear the screen and then execute this particular script. And here you can say it says the current time is 11:47 p.m. and because the condition given in the if statement is false, it directly goes to the else block and executes the message box. And the message box on line number 10 says that have a good day and good night. So this is the if then else end if statement. So basically we can have a condition. If the condition is true, one set of statements is executed, the statements in the if block. If the condition is false, another different set of statements is executed, that is given in the else block. Now let us move on. Now there is another statement, if then else if end if statement. Now sometimes what happens is that we have to test multiple conditions, and depending on which condition is true, the corresponding statements have to be executed. So let us see an example of if then else if end if statement. So here what we have done is we want to find out the day of the week. So I have declared a variable int day of the week, and I'm populating it, that means assigning some value to it by using the weekday built-in VBScript function. And weekday takes the argument which is the date, so I have used the date function in VBScript which returns the current date, whatever is the date today. So that weekday is stored in the int day of week. Now there is another variable strMessage that is just used to populate the message that we want to display to the user. Now the if then else if end if statement works like this. So we can give multiple conditions. So the first condition that we can give is int day of the week is equal to 1. Now the weekday in VBScript starts with 1. So if the weekday is 1, then our message is going to contain Sunday. And otherwise we are going to test another condition, and the second condition is int of weekday is equal to 2. If that is the case, our message is going to contain Monday, and so on for all days of the week. Also notice that we have the else block over here, and if for some reason there is some problem in the code and it is not giving any number between 1 to 7, so we can put unknown day. And finally it displays the message have a happy and concatenates or combines that with the str message, so whatever day we have given. So let us execute it, and notice that today is Monday. So I'm going to execute this VBScript now. So it says have a happy Monday, because what happened, it started testing the conditions right from the very beginning when the if statement started. So it tested whether int day of the week is equal to 1, no, then it goes to the else if part, and then it tests if int day of the week is equal to 2, yes, then it put Monday in str message. And finally on line 22 it said have a happy Monday. Now one other thing to remember is that here we have put some constants which are like unchanging values. So here we have put as 1. Now in scripting these are called magic numbers, because these numbers don't really mean anything to the person who is reading the script. Now VBScript has some built-in constants which we can use. So instead of 1 we can give VB Sunday, and VB Sunday is a more meaningful constant name. And once we use these constants, the person who is reading the script will be able to understand it more clearly what exactly is being tested over here. So for 1 we can give VB Sunday, for 2 we can give VB Monday, and like that. So let us test our script one more time with these changes. And again, you see that we are getting the same message: have a happy Monday. So this is about the if then else if and if statement. So we use this statement when we have to test a number of conditions, and depending on which condition is true, the corresponding actions have to be taken by the script. Now let us go back and see the last kind of if statement, which is the nested if statement. Now nested if statement is the if statement where one complete if statement is within another if statement. So let us see this with the help of an example. So let us say the problem at hand is that we have to find out the biggest of three numbers. So we have declared four variables, A, B, C and biggest, and assigned some values. So let us say that A is 100, B is 15 and C is 80. Now this is our outermost if statement. Now how this if statement starts is on line 6. So here it tests the condition if A is greater than B. So if A is greater than B, then we have already established that out of A and B, A is greater. So the only test we need to do now is to check if A is greater than C or not. So if A is greater than B, then this block of code is going to be executed. So it goes and tests if A is greater than C, then A is greater than B and A is also greater than C, then biggest is A, else biggest is C. Why? Because if A is greater than B but A is not greater than C, then C is the biggest number. One thing to keep in mind in the nested if statement is that the entire nested if statement should be within the outer if statement. So we can see that the nested if statement, and I'm going to select the nested if statement, is from line 8 to line 12. This lies entirely within the if block or entirely within the else block. Now if this condition is false, if A is not greater than B, then it comes to the else part, and within else part what it means is that B is bigger than A. So then we test if B is greater than C, then yes, biggest is B, else biggest is C. So let us test this out. So here we are expecting that A is the biggest number, so that is what it should show in the message box. So yes, it says the biggest number is 100. So let me make B as the biggest number and save the script and run it one more time. And here we can see it is able to correctly find the biggest number is 150. And let me make C as the biggest number and run it one final time. And here we see that the biggest number is 800. So this is an example of a nested if statement. Nested if statement means that one if statement is completely within either the if block or the else block of an other if statement. So I hope in this video you were able to understand the different formats of the if statement. If statement is an example of a conditional statement in VBScript. The conditional statement means in VBScript we can test for a condition. If the condition is true, we can ask a script to take some actions. If this condition is false, we can ask the script to take some other action. So that is all for this video, and see you in the next video. Thank you.